to draw another part of my mapping for my campaign. Going to use my new fancy quill pen. It is super fancy. I enjoy it. It's got this ballpoint nib as well, which makes it easier to do the initial lines and stuff. So, when I bought this nib from Amazon, this quill came with this paper as well. I'm not sure if you can see it, but it's got some dull nautical sort of themes and everything in it, so it's really cool. So I enjoy it, but it does have little faults, so I do have to flatten them out a little bit. So this is the north, similar to the last map I drew. The party has not actually come here yet. Which is fine, this is the actual like north. If you remember the last map that I drew, Tolkien style, it was of the Black Mire. This area is called, I think it's Monkey Island and everything, and there's a town here and a town here as well. So let us just finalize this water piece. So this is sort of like pirate bounty kind of space and everything. I think we're going to have a little bit more shenanigans. I think more light-hearted aspects in this area and stuff, especially on the pirate islands that I've created in the peninsula here. The north town that we have in this space here is probably the most problematic town city we have space, and that's including the one that's overrun by infernal beasts. This is the worst because they don't necessarily care about anything that's going on outside. Very isolationist enforcers and everything actually don't really care what's happening outside. So we have sort of just indiscretion and everything. We actually have not really had any instances. Only one PC, one NPC, has actually come with backstory, but we had to remove that person, unfortunately. But now we have another person, which is a hermit wizard from the north, but we haven't really placed them too specifically. They're more to the east. So as I said before, the Black Mire is down here, and we have that sort of aspect there. Now, got a lot of ink here, so let's sort of just try and finish some of these things off. So we do have hills. So there's valleys and different aspects. In the north, it's more industrial, less agricultural. And that is because it's more focused on finance. There is a large valley pushing up into that area there as well. As well as in the south here is the large valley piece here as well. So we do have some mountains here, so that's just gorge sort of areas and mountains. Let's go back and fill in some of these with some sketching and details. So just put that down for a second and go to one of my other quills, which is this black brows quill with my sort of original quill piece. Can hold a lot of ink. So let's go. So I have in front of me as well the techniques and the styles of the different things that we should have here. Powder hills and everything in the Tolkien style. To help me out, last time I didn't have it in front of me, which didn't really help. I kind of forgot halfway through what I was doing. Also styles of different hand-drawn maps and for dungeons and everything like that. So if I had that as well, I could have probably looked at doing that for a recent character build I did in the Barbarian that has half of a map. Funnily enough as well, fun fact about me, I have a degree in product design, which makes me a little bit like an industrial designer, so I should be able to sketch a lot better than I can, but alas, I did not cultivate that skill. And here we are, not able to really draw anything, but what can you do? So this is kind of like mountainous, but also dusty. This place as well. This area here is sort of deserty. And everything. And then this space here is grass. grassland or valley. In this space here. There's a valley, and I think this we have a major city here as well. There we go. Now we have large forest spaces. Forest land here as well. And some more desert space here. We also have some more pine tree rather than woodlands. Here as well. Here as well. Sort of marsh and land and stuff. Little ships. also have a small town here. Is the northwestern peninsula or coastline. The party has not been here yet. Only one sort of character maybe knows about some pieces of this, and only one NPC has come from the north so far that they've had to deal with. Let's just put in a little bit here. It is coastal and not necessarily agricultural, mostly focused on finance in the north and commerce and trade with the south. You have many valleys that separate the different sectors, and gorge areas, mountainous greenlands and hilly areas, as well as very dense pieces of forestry and everything. This is a werforest where a lot of werefolk are coming from. Everything. The main city in the north is Ravenheim. It is a walled city castle, and people are aloof and absent-minded to what's happening going outside and everything. In this peninsula, I'm more to speaking of what's happening in the north. There's also a town here as well. Speaking to some of the aloofness, they have basically all pirate activity operating on these two islands. Party's not been here yet, as I said, but they'll get there eventually. So that's basically the coastline and everything. Followed the Tolkien style that I've learnt a little bit more closely, so hopefully that sort of makes sense. I'm not sure how you see it, but yeah. I like these new little parchment things I've got, so I'll probably print off a few more of them. And why not? Why don't we stamp this as well? So my little stampy stamp. Still getting used to stamping, but I think also, let's go. So I think maybe next I might make a treasure map with the space and everything. Glad you enjoyed. Thank you, everyone. Enjoy your long rest. And look forward to us exploring the north in the not so distant future.